preparations are done. I'm here, I'm at the airport ready to go to Miss America, but it has been very busy leading up until now. We have had mock interviews. I've been working with a fitness trainer. We have been working on talent, and there are just many other aspects to the Miss America competition than just those three, and we have been working on it every single day up until now. And it's been a whirlwind, but I have enjoyed every single moment and just try to soak it all in because this only happens once in my life. I am a classical pianist. I have been playing the piano. I've been classically trained for about 17 years now, and I'm playing Chopin's Fantasy Impromptu. And I learned this piece actually when I was around 13 years old, but it is one of my absolute favorite pieces in the whole world. And while I could play a more difficult piece, like I mentioned earlier, it's a piece of my heart. It's a piece of who I am, and I think it's one of the best representations of me that I can present to everyone at Miss America and everyone who's watching. So I really hope that everyone enjoys it.
Tell us a little bit about what you tell a young girl who looks at you and says, I want to be just like you one day. I want to be Miss Louisiana. What advice would you give her?
Don't be like me. Be like you. Be who you are, because you are unique and you are different from me. You will bring something different to others' lives. That's why you are here, and that's why we love you for you. So don't be like me. Be like you. Pursue the things that you love, anything that you're passionate about. Go for it. Go for your dreams. Dream big, and don't be afraid to step on the Miss Louisiana stage and show those people, show everyone watching who you're all about, because I think that's the best thing that you can do.
Tell us just a little bit about how excited you really are to get there.
Oh, well, I've got a little bit of nerves, excitement, and just joy. Looking around me, I see so many people who are here supporting me on my journey. So it really puts the title of Miss Louisiana into perspective when I see the friends and I see the family and I see you all here supporting me and cheering me on. It really shows me who I'm representing and why I'm at the Miss America pageant. So I'm just so excited to be there and to represent the state of Louisiana and the people that are here.
You've been in the Miss America program for quite some time. Tell us, what do you feel is the number one thing you've learned from doing this?
It's not just about being pretty and stepping out on stage. It's about showing others, you know, your unique qualities, your unique character, and your personality. I am a neuroscience major now, going to medical school at Tulane next year, and because of the Miss America organization, I've been able to earn over $26,000 in scholarships to help fund my education in medical school. And those are sides of the program that people tend not to see because they only see what the TV shows them, what's on stage. But there's so much more to this organization: the educational pursuits, the leadership opportunities, and the ability to be a servant leader in the community. And that's what I truly want others to know when I'm Miss Louisiana and hopefully as Miss America.
I'm very, very excited, and she worked hard for it, and we are very thrilled, and that's a great honor of her.
Well, she's now leaving for Miss America, so are you looking forward to next week? What is going through your mind now that she's on her way to the big pageant?
I think she is ready, and our Miss Louisiana organization really helped prepare her well. And she's a person who worked very hard, and I think she's ready. She will do good, and I think she will represent our Louisiana well too. And she will try her best to win the crown back home.
It has been so much fun, such a great experience and opportunity, but I've been, you know, working hard on interview prep, mock interviews, on stage question, preparing for my talent as well, and, you know, also just getting my mind focused on this opportunity of a lifetime.
What are you most excited about at Atlantic City?
Definitely September 11th. You know, that crowning moment, you know, you hope it's you. You've worked so hard and you've prepared so long for this moment. You hope that, you know, the end results are you becoming Miss America 2017. And, you know, if it doesn't happen, it's still going to be such an exciting night, and I'll still be Miss Mississippi when I come home. So it's a win-win scenario, but I'm hoping for that bigger crown.
What's your favorite part of competition?
Talent and interview, definitely. They're hand in hand. I love the private interview, an opportunity to really share my story and to meet a new group of people and to, you know, really share how I could be the best candidate to be Miss America 2017. But also talent. It's been a part of my life for as long as I can remember. And singing is my passion. So I want to share that with our nation by hopefully singing that on live television September 11th in the top 10.
Well, tell us a little bit about that talent. What are you going to be presenting at Miss America?
I'm singing Piece of Sky by Barbara Streisand. And it's a difficult piece vocally, but it also has an inspiring message that I can't wait to share with Mississippi. And I sang this at Miss Mississippi for a winning talent. And I hopefully will have another winner in Miss America.
Tell us a little bit about any advice you'd give to little girls in the state of Mississippi about where you are today and how you got here and how you would encourage them.
Be 100% yourself. That is the best version of you. And you're more comfortable with who you are in your own skin, but that's what makes you you and you beautiful. If you stay true to who you are and you're 100% yourself, that's the best advice I could give people, because that was advice that was given to me, that if you just stay true to who you are, you can accomplish so much more and you'll feel so much better about yourself.
So how excited are you?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I'm probably about a 20. I'm so thrilled. I can't wait to get on the plane and embark on this journey. I know it's been a long time coming, but I'm ready to go.
I am so excited. I've seen her work so hard. And it's a little bittersweet because, of course, I'm her mom, and I'm going to miss her. Come here, Mark. And, bittersweet because I'll miss seeing her and being with her, but I am so incredibly proud of her and to see the work she's done and to see her be able to go and show America who she is and tell her story. Gosh, I just can't wait. So that's how I feel.
So you're going to be one of those proud mamas in the stands, aren't you?
I sure am. I'm very, very proud of her. She has been a really special young woman all her life. She's just been a joy to raise, and now it's just a wonderful moment as a parent to be able to see her reap the rewards of a life well lived and good choices and the pursuit of excellence. So and I can really truly say that I've watched her do that all her life, even in the face of odds. So I'm very proud of her.
I'm really excited. I thought I'd be nervous, but I'm not. She's so prepared. I've seen her work extremely hard. And when you have any worries and concerns that what can we do extra or what can she do more, I don't really think she's so prepared. I don't think that's necessary. So we're excited to watch her go do what she's been working hard to do.
Well, tell us, when she was born, did you have any idea this was what was in store for you?
Absolutely none. She was a determined young lady when she was little, but we did not see this one coming.
So you were going to be there cheering her on in Atlantic City?
Absolutely. I'll be there carrying the bags and carrying the banners and probably yelling louder than anybody there. I'm really excited about that part.
I was a little nervous because they had packed every single day full of rehearsals, full of dinners and different events that we would attend, but everyone is so organized and the girls here are so fun, and I have just enjoyed all of my time here. I've enjoyed my time being with these girls, and we even had a spa day and we were able to go to a golf course and we were able to do some driving and putting and chipping. So for me, it hasn't been stressful at all. Of course, we don't get as much sleep as we normally do, but as Miss Louisiana, I don't get much sleep anyway. So it's just a normal day in the life of being Miss Louisiana, but on a greater scale, and I'm able to share it with all of these girls here.
Oh, definitely. The other day, we were surprised with a spa day, and I did not know this was coming. It's a long week during Miss America. It's a week of a lifetime. I'll never forget the experiences that I've had with these girls and the opportunities. But we walked into the Red Door Spa, and we thought that we would just meet with the sponsors and talk and eat. But then they said, oh, by the way, you're going to get to have your own massages. So we had about 15 minutes of our own massages and hand massages and, back massage. And just we got to go in the steam room, and it was a great opportunity to relax after a very long week.
I have grown so much as far as my ability to interview with others, my ability to speak with others. When I was young, I was so shy. I would never talk to strangers. I would never talk to adults. I didn't know how to communicate comfortably in front of an audience, in front of people. And being in this organization has shown me that I don't have to be afraid when I talk about who I am and when I spread information about my platform and I talk to others, and it's given me just a wealth of knowledge as far as speaking goes. I was able to get into four medical schools because of my speaking ability, because of my interviewing ability, and I really credit that to the Miss America organization.
It's to be absolutely and 100% yourself, because that's what Miss America is all about, is being authentic and spreading that message to a young girl watching, or to a young boy, or to anyone in particular, that in order to be your best self, you have to be yourself. That's what's the most beautiful part about yourself. So that's what I've learned throughout this organization, my time here and my time at Miss America, is to be Laura Lee.
The winner of a $1,000 scholarship for lifestyle and fitness in swimsuit is Miss District of Columbia, Sierra Jackson. And tonight's $2,000 scholarship for talent goes to Miss Tennessee, Grace Burgess. Congratulations to both of our preliminary winners. Betty, are you ready to lead them down the runway? Betty is ready. Ladies, take the runway. Let's hear it for both of our preliminary winners. Congratulations to our contestants and tonight's winners. We'll see everyone back here tomorrow night. We'd like to thank our judges, Lois Elaine Smith-Zoll for her amazing singing, Dorothy Benham, Heather French-Henry, Miss America's outstanding team, Nicole Chia, Josh Randall, Mark Angeli, all of our former Miss Americas, Miss America Betty Cantrell as well. Good night, everybody. We'll see you here tomorrow night.
I'm speechless. I'm just speechless. This is so incredible. I never in my life imagined that I would walk away with the preliminary award. I mean, being here, I feel like I've already won. There's so many incredible girls, and I've just had the time of my life, and being able to perform on that stage was amazing enough, but I mean, to walk away with the preliminary award is outstanding.
I think it's really just being very confident and not being afraid to stretch your stuff. And I know that my mom and my aunt, I have to thank them because they let me strut my stuff on driveways, at family reunions, and in the hallways, at the house. And they always remind me that they helped me get my first start in walking. So that, and also just eating and being really healthy. You have to do this the healthy way. You have to make sure you're eating good things and not starving yourself or anything like that, because that's not what it takes to be a Lifestyle and Fitness Award winner at Miss America. You have to be healthy and strong and fit, and I think that's what it takes.
In my state, we catch Mardi Gras beads and crawfish, but tonight I'm here to catch your eye. I'm Justine Kerr, Miss Louisiana. Home of the first King of the Blues, the last American Idol, and hopefully your Miss America. I'm Laura Lee Lewis, Miss Mississippi.
Miss Louisiana, Justine Kerr.
It was the most exciting day of my life, I think, being on the Miss America stage, competing in swimsuit, and being able to show off years of hard work and maintaining a healthy lifestyle and being physically fit is something I'm so, so proud of. So to have that moment on stage was something that I just wanted to suck in and take in as much as I could. And I was just exhilarated by the whole thing.
Miss Louisiana, Justine Kerr.
It's my dream gown. My evening gown is something that I feel so confident in when I wear it. It is the most glamorous thing I own, and it's a different side of me that a lot of people don't get to see because I'm so ingrained in the science field. I'm a researcher, I'm going to medical school, and so they usually see that side of me in the business professional side, but here I get to feel like Miss America. I get to be Miss Louisiana and represent them as a very glamorous and exciting thing for me to do.
Each road I travel only means the more I have to go.
Mississippi.
One, it's a Barbra Streisand piece, and I'm a huge Barbra fan. It's Piece of Sky from the musical Yentl, and it's a vocally difficult song, but I love the message that it also has. Yet, it's a beautiful piece to listen to and a beautiful piece to sing, but it has such an inspiring message at the end that says, can you see me? Can you feel me? Can you hear me? Now watch me fly. And it's kind of a story about the journey I've gone through towards becoming Miss Mississippi, towards becoming Miss America, and all the emotional abuse I had to go through as a young girl because of what I looked like on the outside. And I love singing this song because it has such a deeper meaning to me than it does to anyone else.
The winner of a $1,000 scholarship for lifestyle and fitness in swimsuit is Miss Maryland Hannah Brewer. $2,000 scholarship for talent goes to Miss Arkansas, Savvy Shields. All right, congratulations, ladies. Betty, would you lead them down the runway? Let's hear it for our preliminary winners tonight, all of our contestants. They did a great job. We'll see everyone back here tomorrow night. Many thanks to our judges, our CMNH champion, Angelica Hale, Nina Davalori, Susan Powell, Josh Randall, Mark Angeli, all of our former Miss Americas, and Miss America, Betty Cantrell. Have a good night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow night for our final night of preliminaries.
I'm just so excited. It's been, you know, a dream since I was a little girl to just dance on the Miss America stage and to win a prelim talent award amongst a group of girls who are immensely talented. And during rehearsals, we were even watching every single girl after us and being like, I want her talent. Like, I want the next talent because everyone's so good. And so it was really incredible. And this means so much to me because I never expected this. And I feel so undeserving, but I'm so excited. And I keep wanting to hug everyone because it's my love language, but I keep wanting to hug everyone because I'm just so excited. And this is really an experience of a lifetime.
I felt absolutely shocked. I couldn't even believe it. I had such a wonderful group of girls that I was competing against. So I just felt so humbled when they really chose me. I just can't even believe it. I'm speechless right now. I have to say, I just maintained a very healthy lifestyle and just kept everything in moderation. Like I was just saying, I had cake before my first day here at Miss America. I really tried to have a very moderate lifestyle, and I always was changing up my workout routines. I'm a very outdoorsy girl, so I loved going hiking. I loved paddleboarding and, you know, going and doing yoga with my friends. I just always like to mix it up, and that always helps me stay motivated to work out.
I've been a classical pianist for about 17 years now, and I'm playing my all-time favorite piece. It's Chopin's Fantasy Impromptu. And I learned this piece when I was about 13 or 14 years old, and I fell in love with it almost immediately. And I feel like this was a piece that was meant for me to play on the Miss America stage because it's a piece of my heart. It shows who I am, and it's a great representation of my love for music. And I love to share it with others.
Miss Mississippi, Laura Lee Lewis. Hey, Laura. All right, Laura, your platform is Mentoring Matters. Mentoring Matters strives to help children believe in themselves. So how can a mentor help an at-risk child grow from an insecure and isolated child to a confident and engaged child?
Well, there are a lot of times where a lot of us have felt marginalized for reasons that we don't understand. I certainly know how that feels. But an adult took the time to tell me, Laura Lee, you're special. You can do anything you put your mind to. And that's a message we need to be spreading to our youth, because we need to start respecting one another and believing in one another. And when we start spreading that message now, our future looks so bright.
Thank you very much, Miss Mississippi.
We had our first visitation, and I haven't seen my family for a week and a half now. So a lot of the girls haven't seen their families either, and we were very eager to get past security last night. You could see us holding behind the door, and we were going, come on, come on. So when they finally gave us the go, girls were running, you know, straight towards their families, and I was one of those girls. I ran straight towards my director, David Blackledge, who has just been such a strong supporter of the Miss Mississippi organization as well as Miss America organization. And a family member to me. The Miss Mississippi board has just taken me in with open arms, and I really appreciate them. But then I saw my family, my mom, my dad, my sister, my niece, I call him my brother, I saw everybody, and the emotion. I thought I was going to, you know, cry or get a little emotional, but I was more excited because they've been on this journey with me for so long that I feel like it's their opportunity too. It's their crown also, and we're sharing this moment together.
The winner of a $1,000 scholarship for lifestyle and fitness in swimsuit is Miss Ohio, Alice Magato.
Okay.
goes to Miss Michigan, Ariana Klein. A lot of celebrating, ladies. Let's get it together. Congratulations to all of our finalists tonight. Betty, you can lead them down the runway. Congratulations to our winners and all of our contestants. We'd also like to thank our judges, Suzette Charles, Kira Kazantsev, Sam Haskell, Jane Giroux, all of our former Miss Americas, Tony Eaton, Bill Urban, and Miss America, Betty Cantrell. I'm Dina Blizzard. Have a great night, everybody. We'll see you on Sunday.
I truly and genuinely was not expecting it at all. So when they announced my name, it took me a few seconds to even register that it was me. But I'm just so grateful. I have always been a little bit reluctant presenting a classical piano piece because a lot of people find that not the most entertaining. So I really just brought everything to the table, and I'm glad with how it turned out.
Ohio, Alice Mageltooth.
I was shocked. I was so excited. It was very surreal. My mouth dropped open and I clenched the girls' hands beside me. I could not believe that they said my name. I think it's finding the motivation in every day to get up and get to the gym or get outside and do a workout. Sometimes it's hard to find that motivation, but if you think about what you can accomplish when you are in your best, healthiest health, then that really drives you to get to the gym or get outside. And then also everything in moderation. You don't want to restrict your diet too much because you'll binge out and you'll eat a ton of cookies or a ton of mac and cheese, and that's just not going to help you in the long run. And even with working out, you don't want to overexercise either. So everything in moderation.
Next, Miss Louisiana, Justine Kerr. Hi, Justine.
Hey.
Justine, your platform is A Beautiful Mind, promoting positive mental health. There's more to mental health than the presence or absence of mental illness. What can we do to take care of our minds?
You have to understand that mental health is not just related to mental illness. It's about stress management. It's talking about perfectionism in our lives, because these are things that we deal with every single day. And we talk about inadequacy. For many of us, we wake up in the mornings thinking, I don't have enough time, or I didn't get enough sleep. And that subconscious idea that we are not enough without even thinking that is very dangerous to us. So we need to have these conversations. We need to break the silence about mental health and know that it's about stress management. It's about talking about how we can relieve stress. It's talking about deep breathing, muscle relaxation techniques, but also assertive communication. And these are things that we can start from at a young age with self-worth and work up to a business professional level when we talk about communication and how to work on a business level with other people.
All right, thank you very much, Miss Louisiana.
My support system is everything. When I was able to see them at visitation yesterday, it meant the world because they are here for me to cheer me on, and it really puts the perspective of being Miss Louisiana and being here at Miss America, it puts it all into perspective. It shows me who I'm representing, the people that are here, and I can't really see very well into the audience, so to see Louisiana in huge, huge lights behind the judges just puts a huge smile on my face because I know exactly where they are. I know they're there cheering me on every step of the way. When I'm on stage, I don't feel like I'm the only one on stage. I feel like they're on that stage with me.
Miss Mississippi, Laura Lee Lewis.
It's surprisingly an incredible feeling. I know you're in a swimsuit on stage in front of hundreds of people, but it's a moment to show your confidence and how hard you've worked on being healthy and developing a healthy lifestyle. And I hope that being on this stage in my swimsuit and showing that hard work is spreading a powerful message to not only my state to be healthy and achieve healthier habits, but to our nation, that being healthy can be easier than you think. It's a lot of fun. I've had a great team preparing me. It was a bunch of people preparing me, and I've learned to eat very clean. You can treat yourself every now and then. You just need to make sure that you portion that out and make sure you limit it, but you just eat clean, eat natural, and stay in the gym. Keep active. Change up your gym routine. Don't make it the same thing over and over to where it becomes boring. You know, do cardio one day, arms one day, legs one day. Spice it up a bit. And the best advice I have is to work out with people. Work out with someone because you motivate each other and you have that accountability factor, and it really, really can help you towards your goal and wanting to become more healthier and more physically fit.
Years ago, when Miss America returned home to Atlantic City, we really knew that there was a part of, I don't know, our heart, you know, that was returning home as well. And so it became very important to us to find something local to be a part of and have the contestants share. Miss America Serves then stemmed from our day at the mission and our interaction with the Atlantic City Rescue Mission, and we're really thrilled that the contestants have their philanthropic and their community service spirits in heart. It's a perfect way to balance the intensity of competition and the stress of competition to come and put your hands to service. So we're thrilled that the schools of Atlantic City have jumped in and are filling the food pantry of the Atlantic City Rescue Mission today.
The kids worked very hard collecting their cans. The cans are going to the mission and also the South Jersey Food Bank. We have some of our own families that use both of those facilities. We've had someone in the mission this year because of a fire. We had over 30 families displaced. So not only are we collecting cans for other people, we're giving back to our own community, and it's a good thing. That's a good charity. I think it's really wonderful, and the kids can actually relate to it.
It's a really great cause, and it's something that really puts this week in perspective for us. We have 4 points of the Miss America on the Miss America crown, and one of them is service. So we really wanted to exercise that point of the crown while we were here in Atlantic City and give back to the community that has given so much to us while we've been here. It's unreal. I mean, while we're here in Atlantic City, we don't really get to interact with the public very much. We're under a lot of security, but to see the children has just been, it's been breathing new life into our week, and it's given us so much energy. And just to see their faces, it reminds us that each of us as Miss State, Miss New Jersey, has a job. And whether we walk away with the Miss America crown or not, we still have an impact on kids like these.
These kids are so adorable. I'm so happy to be here right now and help out. And whatever we're here for, we're here to help. They are so excited to see us just as much as I'm excited to see them.
What does Miss America Serves mean to you?
I think it means the world. I love children. I love being able to help others, and I love being able to give back to my community.
It was great to be in the school and see the children. Miss America is all about service, so I'm excited to have a day where we get to really get to the roots of what this organization is about.
Tell us, what does Miss America Serves mean to you personally?
Miss America is built on service. I love being able to give back to my community, and that's one of the greatest things about this organization is that each contestant has a personal platform that they're so passionate about. But not only do we work hard for that one specific issue, but we all work to give back to our communities every day.
We are global citizens in that we all, no matter who we, where we're from, have a part in making sure that every person has a greater quality of life. So I'm so excited to be here.
Today, all the kids greeted us coming into the school, which was really heartwarming because we've been around, you know, we've been in pageant world this whole week, so to be around the kids was so great. And they had brought in tons and tons of cans, and next we're delivering them to a food pantry.
Great. What does Miss America Serves mean to you?
Miss America Serves means giving back. This organization gives so much to us, so this is one chance that we can give back to our communities, whether we know the community or not. So it's going into our communities and just putting our best foot forward and serving people and loving people as best we can.
It just put a huge, huge smile on my face the moment we stepped on the bus and had the opportunity to see these kids come out and greet us. It truly shows us what it means to be a Miss America title holder, what it means to be Miss America, because it takes a step away from competition and shows us what the job of Miss America is. And I'm so excited to be here today, to actually get to be on the floor, to meet the kids, and just to have a good time with all of my other contestants, all of the other sisters that are here.
Richmond Avenue Elementary, 3 years ago when we did our first competition, or our first, obviously, community service, we did make it a bit of a competition with the schools, and Richmond won. And then last year, they won again. So the principal was very cute saying, I'm looking for a three-peat this year. But, you know, we've got six schools involved this year, and they're all raising a great, great deal of food and cans for the pantry. So we'll see. We'll see who wins. But we love these children, and they, I think, look forward to seeing the Miss America contestants every year. They're thrilled for it.
Absolutely.
Just know that the servant's heart and the kindness that you're giving to others through this act today is something very, very important. And I greatly appreciate it. This was Mary's dream to put this together, not only at the Atlantic City Mission, but across the country with Miss America Serves. And I'm so proud of her and what she's done with this. But thank you for being a part of it. And just know that this is what being Miss State and Miss America is all about right here. This is it. And if anything lays on your heart, this is what it should be. Okay? Love you guys.
When we returned to Atlantic City 4 years ago, my wife Mary had an idea about how to involve the contestants in community service that would help the city of Atlantic City. And because she had done so much work with the Los Angeles Mission and the many years that we lived there, she asked me if she could put together a plan to help the Atlantic City Mission. And I said, of course. And it was so well received that we've turned it into a national day of service halfway between each of these young women's reigns in each of their states, and we call it Miss America Serves. And it's a day that happens in April every year, and we raise money with our partners, Children's Miracle Networks, for scholarships and to help sick children. But today, we're at the Atlantic City Mission replenishing the food bank, and I think that's one of the most important things that our program embraces, is this concept of giving back and community service and having a servant's heart. And I want to impress upon each of these young women that while Miss America is a glamorous concept, what she does most of the year is this. She shares her heart and she shares with others, and she's kind, and she understands the meaning of family and those less fortunate. It's about community service. We do over 500,000 hours collectively of community service each and every year, and this is just a prime example of what's possible.
This is kind of what makes Miss America relevant, and what differentiates us from every pageant that tries to emulate us is the aspect of the service. And I love that this is part of the 2 weeks that the contestants are here for, that they do get a chance to kind of go out and be Miss America for a day and really promote their state title by actually giving back while they're here competing for Miss America, because that really is what the whole job is about, being Miss America, is that giving back and that service. And I remember being here last year, and what an experience to kind of just get your hands in it and actually do some good and give back and serve plates of food to the homeless here and cut up potatoes. That's what I did, you know, washing and cutting up potatoes. And it just makes you feel good and useful to actually get your hands in it and give back.
I love it because it's really what the organization is about. It's why so many of us have even gotten involved in this. And I think it's really amazing that we're able to give back to Atlantic City.
It's a great opportunity because it's one of the 4 points of the crown for us. And so it has been an incredible opportunity because we got a break from competition and rehearsals to be able to be here and to do what all of us do on a statewide level. And so it's really neat for all 52 of us to come together and do this today.
It means so much. It's an opportunity to remember why we're all here and what we're trying to accomplish within the Miss America organization. Service is such a key element, and it's important to give back to our communities and give back to those that don't have the opportunities that we have, and really get down to the roots of the service organization that the Miss America organization stands for.
I don't know how many cans total of this, thousands and thousands of cans that'll be used in the preparation of our meals, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So it's really an incredible thing. For the sense of those who are struggling and come here for help, it gives a sense that the community cares about their lives, cares about their needs. For the mission itself, it's uplifting for us, again, on that same kind of note, and again, for the Miss Americas themselves, to show that they have a social conscience and a heart for people in need. And for me, that's one of the most important things in life, is to really care and love others. And because if you don't have that, life isn't just what it should be. I just appreciate the Miss America organization so much for coming and doing, because it's not an easy thing to do. It's not at all. It takes a lot of organization, and these young ladies have a lot of things on their mind about winning, and it shows you here that they are all truly winners now before they even ever get to the contest. These are wonderful women.
Service has always been part of Miss America, but the Miss America Serves Day, that's new, and Mary Haskell actually kind of brought that to life, and I'm so happy she did, because it's made such an impact on our organization and on our communities around us. And I think the girls all love it because it really gives them an opportunity as an entire nation to come together as Miss America organization and have one day out of the year where all of us are giving back on one particular day. And this past year, I participated with the Miss DC contestants, and we visited our retired men and women in uniform, our veterans in the hospital and in retirement homes, and performed our talents for them and helped raise money for Children's Miracle Network Hospitals. And it was just so cool to know that was happening all over the country on that one day. Everybody was giving back and really showing what being Miss America and being a state title holder is all about.
There are no words to sum up this experience. Well, one I can probably think of is amazing. It is an experience that I'm never going to forget. I was walking with one of the hostesses to get to this room, and I said, I can't believe that I've sang on the Miss America stage. I've walked, I've spoken about my platform. What an incredible opportunity that I only get one chance to do. There's only one time I can be Miss Mississippi and one chance that I can be Miss America, and I'm living every moment of this. I'm enjoying every moment of this, and I can't believe I'm here. So this has been an amazing experience.
It's been absolutely incredible. I've had a wonderful time. I've made amazing friends, and I've had incredible memories that I'm going to look back on for the rest of my life. So I'm just thankful for this opportunity to compete at Miss America and to be here representing Louisiana.
My Miss America experience was incredible. It was everything that I had dreamed of. It was everything that I wanted out of the experience of Miss America. I got to meet 51 incredible, incredible women, and they're friends that I will now have for a lifetime. We're already planning a lot of reunions, and we're going to visit one another, and so I have so many memories, and I have grown so much just in the past 2 weeks, so it was exciting for me. I was the second to last called, and so it was just a little nerve-wracking, and I think if you go back and look at my reaction, you can see just how surprised and excited I was to be in the top 15. I'm just proud to have been able to be on that stage on national television and to have represented the state of Louisiana.
Each day there was a different phase of competition. I had interview and talent and, I had interview and evening wear in the same day as well as swimsuit. And then the next day I had talent and the next day I had onstage questions. So having to go through all of those, it was actually very relaxing for me. I wasn't nervous for any of those phases of competition. I knew I had done my best to prepare and all I could do was let it out on stage and do everything I could to let the judges know that I would be the best representative for them.
Tell me what your plans are now.
To sleep for a couple of days. You don't get a lot of sleep as at Miss America, and then I'll pick everything back up and I'll be Miss Louisiana again. And I'm so, so excited to have the job of Miss Louisiana and to represent the state this year.
I'm in a loss for words for the experience I just had. I didn't want to leave. That was the most incredible thing I've ever done. It was such a blessing to be on that stage with 51 other incredible and amazing young women. Savvy Shields being named Miss America was exciting to see. She's a great friend of mine and I'm so very proud of her. But then hearing my name called for top 15, top 12, top 10, and then fourth runner up, it was an incredible experience to have that being called and to see my Mississippi following. I was so blessed and honored to represent Mississippi in that moment. I'm very excited about my platform, Mentoring Matters, and I'm so excited that I get to continually work with my platform as Miss Mississippi this year. And that's incorporated also with civic clubs, organizations, but I also use my major elementary education to focus on literacy and mentoring with a program called Teen Trendsetters, and it's a reading mentoring program. So we work with high school students and elementary students, and they read one-on-one with one another. So that's one of the facets of my program, and I can't wait to continually grow Mentoring Matters across Mississippi.
Are you planning to teach in Brookhaven when you're through being Miss Mississippi?
I don't know, the sky's the limit, but Mississippi is my home, and I hope that I can stay in Mississippi. But this year I have to take the year off being Miss Mississippi and touring around our state, speaking on behalf of the organization as well as my platform. So that's a year from now, so we'll see.